Should be rated R, right?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, which will be cool. I mean, those comics are they're dark horse, right? Yeah. For sure. My last piece of news, I think, the Tarantino project Once Upon a Time in Hollywood picks up Dakota Fanning, who will portray infamous Manson disciple Squeaky.
Oh, nice.
So far, the cast includes Leonardo DiCaprio, Brad Pitt, Burt Reynolds, Tim Roth, Kurt Russell, Michael Madsen, Timothy Olyphant, Margot Robbie, Damian Lewis, Luke Perry, Emile Hirsch, Clifton Collins Jr., Keith Jefferson, and Nicholas Hammond.
Man, that movie is packed.
I heard a rumor that they were talking to Tom Cruise about a part.
Yeah, I think he's attached as well.
Yeah, okay.
But I feel like all of his movies always have a huge cast.
Usually.
Yeah.
Yeah, for the more. But I mean, this is like.
That's insane. I can't imagine the bill.
It's like everybody. They're probably. No, we'll do it for free.
Yeah.
That's all for my news. So let's jump into Rex.
And now it's time for the weekly recommendations.
We'll go back to James.
Oh, man. All right, so my first one is Preacher Season 2.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm like one episode away from finishing it, so I can get ready for Season 3. And what else is it? I don't think either of you are a fan of it, but Stargate.
Oh, okay.
The movie?
Yeah.
The movie's alright.
I like the movie. I mean, I've never watched the TV shows.
The TV shows were garbage.
Okay.
There was one called Stargate Universe that was actually pretty decent.
Uh-huh.
But I think it kind of ended on a cliffhanger and just never got renewed.
Yeah.
But Stargate SG-1 and Stargate Atlantis, they were a shit series. Except Momoa was on Atlantis, I think.
Yeah, I think I remember that, yeah. But, yeah, I just recently watched it because I had nothing to do, and I like the movie because I watched it when I was younger, and
it's
like
Kurt Russell.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
It's got James Spader.
Yeah, I like the whole Egyptian type of theme, so that was pretty cool to me.
Can I share a story real quick?
Yeah, sure.
I have no reason, or I have nothing against the movie.
Yeah.
We had it on VHS, so I saw it as a kid. Mm-hmm. The movie's fine. But my mom, my real mom, forced me to watch that. She lived with us for a while when I was growing up, and she forced me to watch that show. SG-1.
SG-1.
And I fucking hate it.
Richard Anderson.
That's a big reason why I don't like Sci-Fi Channel.
Yeah.
Because I associate it with those garbage TV shows that she always sat there and made me watch. She would watch them for hours, and I was just like, why do you like this stuff?
Yeah.
Why are you so dedicated? Such a dedicated fan. I don't get it.
Sci-fi's got, for me, they've always kind of been hit or miss. They'll have a show that's really good, like The Expanse is really good, and then they'll have a show that's just garbage.
Mm-hmm.
You know, everyone talks about The Magicians being good, but like every time I tried to watch it, yeah, it's on sci-fi. Okay. I couldn't get into it.
I haven't watched it, but I hear good things about it.
Yeah. It wasn't for me, but I mean, they have Battlestar Galactica, which was a great series, and they'll do one that's good, and then there's another one that's crap, and it's like they wasted the budget on the special effects for the good show, and that's why the other show, like 12 Monkeys is a good show.
Oh, yeah.
12 Monkeys, yeah. Did you check out 12 Monkeys? 12 Monkeys is good.
And then the new Channel Zero stuff is pretty decent. For that being basic cable, and for them, that's a pretty cool series.
Yeah, I think Butcher's Block didn't grab me.
But you like the other one, right?
No, End House was really good.
Did you watch the first one yet?
What was it? That was the one with the guy with the teeth.
Yes.
He was like made out of teeth.
Uh-huh.
That one was all right.
I
thought it was good for like half and then kind of lost me about halfway, but I really enjoyed No End House. Butcher's Block started out good, and then it kind of got a little convoluted for me. But that one was crazy gory too.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, anyway, Stargate. Sorry.
Yeah. No, it's cool.
That's so the movie is your...
Right? The movie, yeah. I never watched the show, so I can't...
Don't bother.
...comment on those. Yeah, I don't think I will. It looks pretty shitty anyways. and my last one is Django Unchained. I just watched it.
IFC.
I think it's on regular rotation on IFC right now.
I just watched it the other night, so it was amazing.
As always, yeah.
Yeah. That's it.
Did you... Because we did the Tarantino show last summer.
Mm-hmm.
Had you watched that one recently, Django Unchained, before we did the show?
Yeah, I've seen it,
yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So I didn't know if that was like a movie that you were just kind of remembering off the top of your head, or had you watched it?
Oh no, I just watched it
before the.
I just watched it a couple days ago, I think, maybe 2 days ago.
Mm-hmm.
But I had watched it. I bought it as soon as it came out,
mm-hmm.
Blu-ray. Yeah, I had never seen it in theaters, so.
Oh really?
You didn't go?
I don't think I did. My mind, I don't remember.
It's dope. You didn't see Hateful Eight either, which I was surprised because it was such a kick-ass road show.
I think I watched it right before we did the show.
You were like,
that was your one to catch up with.
Yeah, right? That's right. That was the only one I hadn't watched when we did the Tarantino.
And you were like, Alyssa hates Samuel L.
She's
still there.
She's like, why is he always cussing and yelling every time he talks? And I'm like, oh, this is his character. She's like, you motherfucker.
A motherfucking shark ate me. I just watched Deep Blue Sea the other day, too. Again.
Did you watch that at the Chappelle?
Moment.
The Samuel L. Jackson beer?
Yeah. So those three. Those are mine.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
Chris, what do you got for us? Anything?
Well, if you missed 2001, I can't help you out there. That's kind of moving around in a roadshow format, though. It's kind of playing in a few theaters for a weekend or so, and then it's moving on. You and I talked last week about this, Wesley. Westworld, season 2.
Mm.
It's fucking awesome. Like, the first season was great. This season has gotten a lot better, and they've taken some detours in the park that lead to some other really great parks. And I can't...
That's what I was curious about, if they were going to expand on that, and I'm glad that they...
They do. They do. And they spent pretty much an entire episode in one of the other parks, and it was one of the best I'd ever seen.
Hold the phone. So there's more than one park?
Spoiler.
Oh, man. I never finished the first season.
They teased it at the end of the first
HBO
season.
Subscription ran out. So.
Yeah. Get back into it.
I'm not paying for that shit again.
Get back into it. But they tease at the end of the first season that there's other parks.
Okay.
And fourth or maybe fifth episode in, they spent an entire episode.
Okay.
Or close to an entire episode in one of the other parks, and it was real great.
Nice.
Jeffrey Wright, Tandy Newton, Ed Harris, Evan Rachel Wood, they're all doing great, great work on the show. They're acting the shit out of that show, and I really enjoy it. And even the last episode, to me, felt like it could have been a season finale because there was so much going on, and there's still like 3 episodes left this season.
Nice.
So,
did you see when I think we posted it? I put it up in our story because I was at the premiere in LA. They did.
I remember you
at the ArcLight.
Yeah, when you went to go see You Were Never Really Here, right?
Yeah,
they had like the
they were setting up the red carpet, so I was right there. I got to see them, pretty much building it, which was a cool experience.
That's awesome.
Yeah,
good show. I highly recommend that one. And I know Vic shot it out. What was that? Evil Dead show, I think. He was talking about Legion.
Oh.
And season 2 is on now, and season 2 has been great. There's some people that want to knock it, but it's been really good. It's focused a lot more on individual characters some episodes, and it's been great. There's been a couple episodes that I thought were some of the best they've ever done, too.
Nice. Dan Stevens.
Very cool.
Yeah, Dan Stevens. He's awesome.
Mom. Yeah, not according to somebody.
Sleeper.
Is that all you got?
Yeah, just those two.
All right. Nice. I didn't want to just cut him off, you know. Now back onto me. No. So I have two.
Okay.
My first one is going to be Sharksploitation because I love that shit.
Deep Blue Sea?
No. It's a little film called The Reef. It's rated R. It came out in 2010. It's 1 hour and 34 minutes. It's got a 79 on Rotten. Set in the backdrop of Australia, a sailing trip turns into a nightmare as a group of friends fight survive after their boat hits a piece of the reef. And so they're forced to either hang out on the boat that's ultimately sinking, and then be, you know, stranded there. And the catch is that the current, I guess, that they're in is pushing them every minute further out to sea. And so he's like, no, we need to swim this way to back to what they call Turtle Island. They can't see it, but he says, we're only maybe 10 miles away. But if we stay here, we're going to drift so far out to sea that we're going to end up dying once this boat goes under. And so they decide to swim, and then they start being hunted by a great white. But it's like they're literally, it's like a hopeless situation. But the way that it's executed very well, the tension, and you don't see any sharks for like 45 minutes in. Okay. So they really, really build up these characters for you until things start to happen. And the biggest thing that I love is that I don't know how they shot this safely or what they did, but they used real sharks. There is no CGI whatsoever in this. And that's what makes this film stand apart from everything else. There's nothing cheesy about it. It looks like you want to be like, holy shit, is this a snuff film? Like, it's nuts, all right? Yeah. So, yeah, The Reef, check it out. I don't know if it's streaming on anywhere. It was on Netflix for a little bit, but it shouldn't be. It should be a couple dollars to rent. You could probably rent it. It's called The Reef.
Nice.
An Australian picture that you probably haven't seen yet. And then I wanted to do a soft review for the new Upgrade movie.
Oh, did you see it?
Yes.
Oh, you bastard.
I fucking saw it, and it's awesome, man. It's probably the, I want to say, like, one of the top, like, action sci-fi films that have come out so far this year. It's done by Lee Whannell, who did the first two Insidious films. He wrote them.
I think he directed the third.
Yeah, he did. And then he worked with James Wan on the first Saw. And he's done some acting bits. But that guy's underrated. I love his work. And this is probably his best, or my favorite piece that he's done so far. You need to check it out. It's got an 86 on Rotten. Let me do the synopsis. In the near future, a couple is robbed and left for dead. Gray Trace survives, but is paralyzed from the waist down. He is then given the opportunity of a lifetime. And I think everybody knows what that is from the trailers. it's amazing. Deserves all the... I feel like people are really jocking this film right now, but for good reason. The choreography, the action scenes, it gets to the point. It feels like an indie film. In certain aspects, but with a budget.
Yeah.
Like, they do so much with... I feel like they probably had little to work with, and that made them more, maybe, how do you say, creative. And so, and just everything about it, man. It's so, how do you say, like, inventive. And just, it was refreshing. I'm glad I went to see it in theaters, for sure, and I hope you guys will go see it, too.
It's already out now, right?
Yeah. Okay. And Logan Marshall Green, people are sleeping on him. Yeah. The American Tom Hardy.
Oh, man, Corey was a great show. I'm sad that they
canceled that. They shouldn't have, man. I think I blame Cinemax, just like Outcast.
I finally saw another trailer for Outcast, but still not coming until July. That's over 2 years since it aired, man.
Yeah. I guess it's big in the UK. Like I was telling you, I saw that the UK has been done with season two. It's already out.
Why release in the UK? Because it's an American show.
Yeah. I don't know if maybe it just did really well over there, but they've already gotten it. So it's pretty strange.
Well, hopefully they don't cancel that either. I'll be waiting for July when it starts up again. That was a good show.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I mean, that should be that guy's bread and butter now that Walking Dead's just falling to pieces.
Are you still watching The Walking Dead, either of you?
I'm caught up.
Really?
I'm not caught up.
Gave up on that shit, man. I couldn't do it anymore.
Well, you know, last week we talked about...
you haven't listened?
I haven't listened.
Oh, Andrew Lincoln's leaving after this season. And so
it's... The show's dead, then.
And,
kill it.
Yeah, and Maggie's gone,
too. Maggie's leaving.
I heard that she got, like, a pilot for CBS or ABC or something in the fall.
I have no idea. But I know her contract's up, and she said she's leaving after her contract's up after this season. Yeah, pretty much. But yeah, and then Rick is supposed to leave before the season is over. So.
And of course, Daryl's taking over. They're offering him like shit tons of money.